Dear students, today we are going to learn the design steps of compression members. Okay, so in design steps of a compression member, there are 6 steps. First step is design stress in compression member is to be assumed. Means first we need to assume the design compression stress. Okay, and for different types of rolled sections and angle sections there are different stresses. Okay, and that is for rolled sections and beams, F of CD, that is nothing but the design compression stress is 135 Newton per mm square. Fine. Then for angle struts, F of CD, that is design compression stress, is equals to 90 Newton per mm square. In first step, we have to assume the design compression stress for a member. Okay, if it is a rolled sections and beams are there, at that time you have to take F of CD as 135 Newton per mm square. Okay, if you are going to design angle strut, at that time you have to take F of CD is equals to 90 Newton per mm square. Fine. Now second step, I'll write second step is effective sectional area required. Means your effective sectional area required, that is nothing but A, is equals to P of D divided by F of CD. Once you assume the compression stress, for that stress what is the area required, and this area required, that is nothing but a capital A, is equals to P of D divided by F of CD. This A you will get it from this formula. Fine. I will write down third step. In third step, you need to select a section for a effective area, and according to that effective area you have to calculate the R minimum, that is nothing but radius of gyration. Fine. Once you will select a section, okay, that is nothing but a section for a required area, you will get it from the steel table, and from that steel table you have to select the area, and according to that selected section, you have to calculate the R minimum. Fine. Now, fourth step, I will write. Once you calculate the R minimum which is there in your third step, go to the fourth step. That is nothing but to find the effective length. Okay, to calculate the effective length, you must know the end conditions. That is nothing but which type of support you have provided. Okay, and deciding which type of connection you are going to give. Fine. Effective length, that is depend on the type of support you are going to provide and the type of connection which you are going to provide. Based on these two things, you are going to calculate the effective length for a section. Fine. Next, I will write step fifth. Once you calculate the effective length, the next step is to calculate the slenderness ratio. Okay, that is nothing but KL by R. KL by R is equals to slenderness ratio. And this slenderness ratio is denoted by lambda. Okay, and after calculating the slenderness ratio, you need to go for the design stress, that is nothing but F of CD, and the load carrying capacity, that is nothing but P of D. Okay, once you calculate the slenderness ratio, that is lambda, you need to calculate the F of CD, that is nothing but design compressive stress, and next step is to calculate the capacity, or you can say the load carrying capacity of a section. It is denoted by P of D. And the final step is thank you. revise the section if calculated P of D is differs considerably from the design load. Okay, you have to revise the section if your P of D is less. Okay, are you getting it? Your P of D should be more. If it is coming less, then you have to revise the section considerably if it comes differs and from the design load. Fine. So these are the 6 steps to calculate the design of compression members. So let us begin with the problems. Okay, so this is the first problem of design of a compression members. Okay, so in a truss, a strut 3 meter long consists of 2 angles, I say 100 by 100 by 6 mm, and find the factor strength of the member if the angles are connected on both ends of 12 mm gusset by, first condition is 1 bolt, second one is by 2 bolts, and third one is by welding. Okay, so this is your question, and as per this question, this is nothing but the scenario of your compression sections. Okay, so this pink colored is nothing but a gusset plate of thickness 12 mm. Fine, and these blue colored are nothing but the angles, or you can say the equal angles, okay, which are connected back to back to the gusset plate with the help of bolt or welds. Okay, and the size of this ISA is 100 by 100 by 6. So let us begin with the solution. We need to find out the factored strength. If the 1 bolt is connected, or 2 bolt is connected, or if it is a welding. Fine. So solution will be, first step in calculation will be always from steel table. Okay, whatever they have given the sizes, according to that we need to calculate the sizes of your, or you can say the properties of a given sizes. Fine, for ISA 100 by 100 by 6, what are the sectional properties that we need to first find out? So in that step, from steel table, for ISA 100 by 100 by 6 mm, okay, area is 1167 in mm square. Fine, that is nothing but A of E. Second thing is center of gravity, that is C by Y and C XX is equals to 26.7 mm. Next, R by Y and R XX, that is equals 30.9 mm. Moment of inertia about XX axis and YY axis is 111.3 into 10 raised to 4 mm raised to 4. So these data is from steel table of page number 4 for a size ISA 100 by 100 by 6 mm. Fine, then next step. Next step to calculate P of D, that is equals effective sectional area into F of CD. Okay, so this is nothing but your equation 1. Now we know A of E. Now we are interested to find out F of CD. To calculate this F of CD, we need to assume the yield stress. That is nothing but assume yield stress F of Y is equals to 250 MPa. 250 MPa. Now, second thing is we need to assume buckling class. We need to assume buckling class. If you go to IS code book, that is nothing but 800/2007, page number 44, page number 44 of IS 800/2007. Okay, over there you will get the buckling class for a angle. For a angle, referring that the buckling class is C. Buckling class is C. Fine. Now, let us take the first condition. Let us take the first condition. That is nothing but for 1 volt. 1 volt. Now, KL is equals 1.0 into L means the length. That is nothing but they have given the strut length as 3 meters. Convert it into mm, that is 3000. Okay. Now K over here I am taking 1.0 and L I am taking 3000 mm. Why I am taking K is equals to 1.0? For a 1 volt, it is acting like a hinge. That's why if you refer a standard values which is there in your code book, okay, it will, for 1 volt it will show K value as 1. That's why I am taking K value as 1 over here. Now after calculating, I will get the answer as 3000 mm. That is K into L. Now find out R, that is radius of gyration. Or you can take this is from your code book. Sorry, steel table. That is nothing but 30.9 mm. Once you got these values, next step is to find out the lambda. That is nothing but your slenderness ratio. Lambda formula is what? KL by R. Okay, substitute these two values in lambda equation. KL is nothing but your 3000 by R is 30.9 mm. After calculating, you will get lambda as 97.08. which is nearly equals to 97. Once you got this value, go to the IS code book. Go to the IS code book of page number 42. Of page number 42, and calculate the value of F of CD. Calculate the value of F of CD. Okay, to calculate this F of CD, we need to find out first this lambda and this F of Y. For F of Y, that is nothing but 250 MPa, and correspondence to lambda, that is nothing but 97, you will get the value of f of cd is equals to 111.02 newton per mm square. That is after linear interpolation. Fine. So this is f of cd. Now substitute this f of cd into equation 1. Now your equation 1 becomes p of d is equals a of e is 1167 into f of cd. F of cd is this value, that is 111.02. Calculate these values. After calculating, you will get p of u, that is, or else you can take p of d is equals 2 times the area of this angle into f of cd. After calculating, you will get this value, that is nothing but p of d for case 1. Now why I am taking over here 2? Because area of a ISA 100 by 100 by 6 mm is 1167, but I am applying, or I am taking over here 2 angles, that's why I have multiplied over here 2. Fine. Now we will go to case second, that is for 2 bolts. Similarly, follow these steps till here. That is nothing but KL is equals to, now here for 2 bolts, K value will be 0.825 from code book, into L is same, which is equals 2475 mm, and R is equals to same, that is 30.9 mm, and lambda is equals this 2475 divided by 30.9. After calculating, you will get the value of lambda as 80.09, which is nearly equals to 80 we will take, Now, once you got this lambda, find out f of cd. To calculate this f of cd, go to page number 42 of IS 800-2007, and over there check f of y, that is already we have assumed as 250 MPa, and for lambda is equals to 80, what is the correspondence value for f of 250? That is nothing but 136 newton per mm square. Once you got this f of cd and that lambda, substitute these things into equation 1. Now p of d is equals to a of e. A of e is for 2 angles, into f of cd is 136 newton per mm square. After calculating this, you will get the value of p of u as 317.42 kilonewton. That is p of d for your case second. Now let us move with the third case. That is nothing but for welding. Okay, now for welding, once welding term is used in your question, it means the support will be in a fixed manner. Okay, welding makes the joint rigid. Okay, now for welding K value will be 0.65. okay, and L is 3000. After calculating, you will get the value as 1950 mm, and R is equals to 30.9 mm. So calculate the lambda. Lambda is equals KL by R, where KL is 1950 divided by R is 30.9. So lambda is equals 63.10. Now let us move to find out f of cd. To calculate f of cd, go to the page number 42 of IS 800 and 2007 and find out the value of f of cd, that is 162.86 newton per mm square, and substitute these values in equation 1. P of D is equals to area 2 times the area of one angle into F of CD is this value, 162.86, and after calculating you will get the value as 380.11 kilonewton. That is the factor strength of a joint for condition 3, that is nothing but for welding. Fine. So now over here you have got the values of PD in three numbers. That is, this is nothing but for first criteria, and this is for your second criteria, and this is for your third criteria. So this is nothing but the end of your problem.